The Lord deals bountifully with men when he gives himself unto them as their portion and inheritance, when he gives his Son unto them and all things along with him, when he gives his Spirit unto them and the graces of it, and every daily needful supply of grace. This is a quote coming to you from John Gill's commentary. In this broadcast, we are continuing the theme of resolutions in our new series entitled, In the Beginning Was the Word. In this particular broadcast, we will cover the new subject of praising the Lord as we deal with resolution number 33, as found in Psalm 13, verse 6, which says, I will sing unto the Lord because he has dealt bountifully with me. Now, when we look at Psalm 13 and we examine this psalm to study it, we find out that the psalm begins in sorrow, but it ends in joy. Psalm 13, verse 1, David said, How long wilt thou forget me, O Lord, forever? How long wilt thou hide thy face from me? But then when we get to the end of the psalm, verse 6, here we find David saying, I will sing unto the Lord because he has dealt bountifully with me. Now notice the psalm began in sorrow, but it ended in joy. Now I want to tell you, I am coming today with a word from the Lord for someone who is listening to this message. God wants me to tell you that the end is going to be different from the beginning. You may have begun in sorrow, but you're going to end in joy. You may be facing a hard time now, but the end will be different from the beginning. And in all God's works, we see this great likeness running throughout. We can see a change from bad to good. A situation appears that's very bad, but in the end, it turns out to be good. Hope deferred changes to real enjoyment. The daylight succeeds the darkness of night and disperses it. Health and strength follow a bed of sickness. Inward joy follows after a long period of outward sorrow. And this is life's history of all God's most chosen servants. But how is this brought about? How is it that in the life of God's most chosen servants, how is it that the end is different than the beginning? And the reason being is because there is a God in heaven who deals bountifully with us. As David said in verse 6, I will sing unto the Lord because he has dealt bountifully with me. We find this throughout the scriptures, this concept of God as one who deals bountifully with us. In Psalm 84:11, it says, For the Lord God is a sun and shield. The Lord will give grace and glory. No good thing will he withhold from them that walk uprightly. Psalm 85:12 says, Yea, the Lord shall give that which is good. Romans 8:28 says, And we know that all things work together for good to them that love God, to them who are the called according to his purpose. Ephesians 1:3 says, Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has blessed us with all spiritual blessings in heavenly places in Christ. And then James 1:17 says, Every good gift and every perfect gift is from above and cometh down from the Father of lights, with whom is no variableness, neither shadow of turning. Now we see this God who deals with bountifully with us throughout the Bible. He withholds no good thing from them that walk uprightly. He gives that which is good. He turns everything around for good in your life. He has blessed you with spiritual blessings in heavenly places in Christ. There is no variableness, neither shadow of turning with him. Every good gift, every perfect gift comes from him. He is the God that deals bountifully with you. And in this message today, we want to focus on him as with that feature, with that characteristic. We want to get a greater revelation of him. This is the kind of God that we serve. He's the God that deals bountifully with us. David said in verse 6 of Psalm 13, I will sing unto the Lord because he has dealt bountifully with me. Now, when you hear those words, what exactly did David mean? What does this entail when you think of him as the God who deals bountifully with you? Well, first of all, it signifies a bountiful rewarding of good things instead of evil, which we rather do deserve. None of us deserves any good from God. We deserve hell, but yet he gave us salvation through his Son, Jesus Christ. He has given us eternal life through faith in Jesus and what he did on the cross. Here it's signifying that he gives us, bountifully rewards us with good things instead of evil. In those words, he deals bountifully with us are the words compensation, rewards, recompense. He treats you with favor. He deals kindly or favorably with you. He gives you good things instead of evil. He bestows on you blessings of providence and grace. He blesses you with spiritual blessings. But oh, not only that, but he delivers you. He delivers you from trouble in such a way that it's exceeding abundantly above all your expectations. But he doesn't just deliver you from trouble. He delivers you from your enemies. And he removes the affliction under which you have groaned. And oh, that's not all. And here he also gives you the oil of joy for mourning, the garment of praise for the spirit of heaviness. He causes you to rejoice with joy unspeakable and full of glory. And he exchanges that cry of despair. How long, O Lord, how long shall my enemies be exalted over me? He exchanges that cry of despair with a joyful song of thanksgiving. Like David said, I will sing unto the Lord because he has dealt bountifully with me. That's the kind of God that we serve. He's the God who deals bountifully with you, with us. The treasury of David said, God deals with us like a God. He lays his fullness open to us. And of that fullness have all we received, and grace for grace. Now, in order to appreciate this God who deals bountifully with us, with you, I want us to look back at Psalm 13 and find out what was going on in David's life at the time. Now, remember, the end of the psalm is different from the beginning. The psalm shows stages from mourning to rejoicing. And also remember that this is the word God gave me to tell you. Your end is going to be different from your beginning. Because of the God that we serve, the God who deals bountifully with us. Okay, listen to how David started off this psalm. He was crying out, how long because he was feeling forgotten by God. Let me ask you, have you ever cried out? How long? Have you ever felt like you were forgotten by God? David cried out, how long? Feeling that God has hid his face from me. How long? He was taking counsel in his soul. He had sorrow in his heart daily. How long, Lord? How long shall my enemies be exalted over me? He felt that these enemies were indeed exalted over him. And he was afraid that his enemies would be able to say, I have prevailed against you, David, and I'm going to rejoice when I see you moved. David was afraid of that. That's why he cried out, how long, how long, how long, O Lord? Then we go through the Psalms and we find that in different situations, David said, the sorrows of death compassed me. The pains of hell were laid upon me. I found trouble and sorrow. I was greatly afflicted. Everything seemed dark, depressed, sad. I was disturbed in my mind. Troubles ruffled my spirit. My confidence in God was shaken by the troubles and the sorrows. I felt like my enemies had overmatched me and exhausted me. I was brought low. Let me ask you, have you ever been brought low? Have you ever felt like the devil was overmatching you and exhausting you? You were brought low. Then David also said, he said that he was pressed with uneasy fears, and he felt like he was falling from his confidence in God. He passed through a season of great danger where his soul was agitated and terrified. But yet, at the end of the psalm, after all these emotions gone through his soul, at the end he was able to say, I will sing unto the Lord because he has dealt bountifully with me. Do you see how the end is different from the beginning? What made the change? Adam Clark said, that heart is turned to God's praise, which has a clear sense of God's favor. God showed up. The God who deals bountifully with him showed up and changed the situation. The treasury of David said this, the world wonders how we can be so merry under such extreme miseries. But our God is omnipotent, who turns misery into felicity. The end is different from the beginning. The end will be different for you from the beginning, because we serve a God who's omnipotent, and he turns misery into felicity. He is the God who deals bountifully with us. Now, in closing, I want to show you what exactly happens when this God who deals bountifully with us shows up on our behalf. He shows up and he shows off. This is what happens. First of all, bonds are loosed. In Psalm 116, verse 6, we read David saying, O Lord, truly I am thy servant. I am thy servant and the son of thine handmaid. Thou hast loosed my bonds. When the God who deals bountifully with us shows up, he looses our bonds. You are freed from your chains. He releases and loosens the bonds of affliction, of disease, of pain, and even death. He delivers you from trouble or distress. He rescues you from your enemies. Oh, this is the kind of God that we serve. He deals bountifully with you. He looses your bonds. Another thing that happens when he shows up, he brings your soul out of prison. Psalm 142:7 says, Bring my soul out of prison, that I may praise thy name. The righteous shall compass me about, for thou shalt deal bountifully with me. When God shows up as the God who deals bountifully with you, he brings your soul out of prison. And that word prison there is used symbolically as a metaphor for trouble and distress. He brings your soul out of trouble and distress. He sets you at perfect liberty. He brings you out of the present condition you're in that is like a prison. You feel like you're shut up in this place, encompassed with foes. He brings you out of the straits, the distresses, the difficulties that are surrounding you and pressing you on all sides, where you feel like you're hemmed in by enemies. Oh, when the God who deals bountifully with you shows up, he brings your soul out of prison. Another thing that he does when he shows up, he returns your soul unto its rest. Psalm 116 verse 7 says, "Return unto thy rest, O my soul, for the Lord has dealt bountifully with thee." When he shows up, this God that we serve, who deals bountifully with you, he will return your soul unto rest. You will be joyful again. You will return to your former tranquility and calmness that you enjoyed before the attacks of the enemy came your way. You will have this freedom from fear and anxiety, and you will resume your former peace and freedom from alarm. God will restore you unto cheerful confidence in him, where you're resting in his goodness. Oh, when he shows up, he will cause your soul to return and to rest. And then lastly, when this God that we serve, this God who deals bountifully with you, when he shows up, the righteous compass you about. Psalm 142, 7 says, "The righteous shall compass me about, for thou shalt deal bountifully with me." What God will cause is the righteous will come, they'll encircle you, they'll flock to you from all parts. They'll desire your society, your friendship, your influence. They'll regard it as a privilege and an honor to be associated with you. They're going to flock to you to congratulate you on your marvelous deliverance that God wrought on your behalf. They're going to want to hear your experience, your testimony, and then they're going to join in thanksgiving and praise to God for this marvelous deliverance. Oh, hallelujah. When this God that we serve, the God who deals bountifully with you, shows up, the righteous will compass you about. David said in Psalm 13:6, "I will sing unto the Lord because he has dealt bountifully with me." Remember, he started off with a cry of despair. "How long, Lord, shall my enemies be exalted over me?" But he ended up with the words, "I will sing unto the Lord because he has dealt bountifully with me." The end will be different from the beginning. As in the case of David, look what happened. God loosed his bonds, brought his soul out of prison, caused his soul to return to former tranquility and calmness, and caused the righteous to flock to him, to desire his friendship and influence. And because of that, David said, "I am resolved, I am determined, I will sing unto the Lord because he has dealt bountifully with me." What was meant for evil, he turned it around for my good. Our time is up for today's broadcast, but I encourage you, stay tuned for our next teaching as we continue our study of resolutions as found in the book of Psalms. This is Connie Giordano with Walking in Truth Ministry, praying that this revelation of God as the one who deals bountifully with you will lift your faith today to believe for the impossible, to believe for what your enemies are saying will never happen. But the God who deals bountifully with you will make it happen. In Jesus' name, amen.